Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel, and in today's video we are going to be studying about air and the atmosphere. This is the episode 4 of the air and the atmosphere series for grade 6. So let's get started. First of all, I want to tell you guys that we studied photosynthesis and combustion in the last episode, and in today's episode we are going to be studying about the fractional distillation of the air. In order to obtain large quantities of oxygen and nitrogen, air is turned into a liquid and it is fractionally distillated. So in order to obtain large quantities of oxygen and nitrogen, air is turned into liquid and fractionally distilled. The air is filtered then to remove any dust and is then cooled and compressed until it reaches 200 degrees centigrade. So first they are saying, in order to obtain the large, because oxygen is not in a small quantity in the air, it is in a large quantity. So they are saying, in order to obtain that large quantity of oxygen and nitrogen, the air is turned into liquid. It does not remain in gas form, it is turned into a liquid and it is fractionally distilled. The air is filtered. It is filtered like we filter the water, and here the air is filtered to remove the dust if there is any, and then it is cooled and compressed until it reaches 200 degrees centigrade. While the air is being cooled, the water vapor condenses and removed by special filters. While the air is being cooled, the water vapor is condensed and is removed by special filters. Carbon dioxide, the carbon dioxide gas, freezes at minus 79 degrees centigrade and is removed. Oxygen turns into a liquid at 183 degrees centigrade and nitrogen at minus 196 degrees centigrade. The liquid air passes into the warm bottom of a fractionating column. The liquid air, as we know that the air is turned into a liquid, then the liquid air passes into the warm bottom of a fractionating column. The nitrogen rises to the top and is piped off and stored. Then the nitrogen rises to the top and is piped off and stored. Liquid oxygen, the oxygen that is made into liquid, as we know that they turn the air into liquid. Now the air also contains oxygen. So when the air is turned into liquid, the oxygen is also turned into the liquid. So the liquid oxygen collects at the bottom of the column and is piped off and stored. So the nitrogen rises to the top and is piped off and stored, and the liquid oxygen collects at the bottom of the column and is piped off and stored. Since argon has a boiling point very near to that oxygen, a second fractionating column is used to separate the argon from oxygen. So the column is piped off, the column of the oxygen is piped off and stored. Now argon, they are saying that argon has a boiling point very near to the boiling point of the oxygen. A second fractionating column is used to separate argon from oxygen. A second fractionating column. They use a second fractionating column that is used to separate the argon from the oxygen. So right now we have studied the chapter of air and the atmosphere. This was the fourth episode of the series Air and the Atmosphere for grade 6, and today we have studied the fractional distillation, and in the next episode we are going to be studying about the properties of gases in the air. Bye bye, see you next time.